I know, I'll take my medicine. Like
yes, I know, because it makes you feel better. But from now on, we're not going to be friends with anyone but each other. I was wrong to think we could be. We're just going to do what we have to take care of ourselves, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to get out of here and I need a bit of help.
Get out? What for? What sort of stupid question's that? Oh, geez, you only got 6 months, not even that with good behaviour.
Well, whatever it is, it's too much. Look, I'm going to go off my brain if I have to stay in here another month. So you're going to help or not?
You know, Rita, you could learn a lesson from Kath.
What do you mean?
When it came to it, she couldn't kill Williams, no matter how much she might have deserved it. Cold-bloodedly taking somebody else's life is wrong.
I tell you now, it'll be a disaster. Governor wouldn't have agreed in the first place if it had been anyone but Mummy's little pet here.
Oh, just shut up, Rodney.
No, Del. Let him go. After all, he's said it enough times. What he means is that my mother is unfairly using her position to help me. Isn't that right, Roddy?
Well, everyone knows it's true.
Rodney!
Just like everyone knows why you always stick up for him.
Time. I thought I told you.
Yeah, all right. I was just waking up.
Look, you're not the only one in here who thinks they've been hard done by.
Well, how would you feel if you were stuck in here while your mate got off on a bond?
I'd make the most of it. Now you get a move on.
Yeah. I'll get a move on, all right. Right out of here. Hey, Vic, come in here for a sec.
What's up?
I've made up my mind. It's today.
Yeah, all day. So what?
I'm going to get out of here, so you've got to help.
Hang on a minute, I'm still thinking about it.
I told you I'd smuggle stuff into you. You'll clean up.
Oh, yeah. So what's the big plan?
Look, it's a breeze. I dreamed it up last night.
Yeah, that'll be right. So when you wake up, you can tell me all about it.
It can't miss. It won't hurt you to hear me out, will it?
Suppose not.
Look, I'll talk to you later. It's like bloody Burke Street around here.
Mm. Suit yourself.
Oh, I love the ones of Egypt. Those pyramids. Imagine the stories they could tell.
Yeah, like how many tourists have taken slides of them.
Well, he went there once with Walter. He offered me one of those first-class tickets on the Italian cruises.
Silly me, I cashed in the tickets.
Is everybody on a go slow today? Now, come on, get a move.
I'm coming,
on.
Mrs. M.
Oh, Patterson, you'll be moving up to maternity tomorrow morning after showers. Make sure everything's packed, will
tomorrow?
You?
Tomorrow?
You heard what I said.
Oh, it's so exciting. It's all beginning.
Oh, thanks.
Well, it beats folding sheets, kiddo.
Well, you're always up there talking to Patty Higgins anyway.
Yeah, but it's different being stuck up there all the time. Can't you do something?
Oh, Lexie.
Well, you're top dog. Tell Reno to put it off.
Oh, yeah. Why don't I tell her to open the gates for an hour after lunch, too?
She's already said no to you. What good would it do if Rita speaks up?
You gonna or not?
Oh, if you say so. Come on, Liz.
Thanks.
Oh, for the last time, ladies, come along.
I'm coming, Mrs. M.
Oh, sorry, I didn't realise you wanted to use the iron.
I thought your shift started half an hour ago.
Oh, Mrs. Reynolds doesn't mind me coming in late once in a while, as long as everything's prepared in advance.
I see. Well, I'll take a shower while you finish.
Joyce is still in there.
Oh.
About last night.
What about it?
Well, I wouldn't want you to get the idea we're in the habit of staying out.
What you do is your business. I'm going to get some coffee.
Oh, no!
Mervyn, what happened?
I've ironed in another damned crease.
Oh, never mind. I'm running late enough as it is.
Join the club.
Oh, good morning. Have you had some breakfast?
Oh, I was just thinking that I might whip up some French toast. Anyone interested?
Oh, that sounds lovely, as long as there's no trouble.
It won't be a jiffy.
Oh, Mervyn, I'm sorry, but there aren't any eggs. I meant to get some on the way home last night and some bread, but, well, I forgot.
Coffee will be fine. I'll put the kettle on.
Oh, Mervyn, what's the matter? You're a nervous wreck.
I can't help it, love. Not with her around. It isn't going to work, Joycey. Look what happened last night.
Oh, I don't remember. What did happen?
When we came home, she sat there smirking at us in our own house.
Oh, it won't be much longer, and we did promise.
All right, look, I better go and have a shave. Look, I'm sorry about the shirt.
Oh, love. That doesn't matter. Oh, and Mervyn, on the way back, bring me a couple of aspirin, will you?
Oh,
I thought you might like to know I've put in an offer on the flat. I think they're going to find it agreeable.
Oh, I'm sure they will. Well, things seem to be falling into place for you.
Hmm. Well, time's getting on. I'd better take that shower.
Oh, I'm sorry, but Mervyn's just gone in there to have a shave. He won't be very long, I hope.
You look busy. Want a coffee?
It's, black.
Right. Coming up. Don't you think yourself lucky you weren't on muster this morning?
No trouble?
Oh, well, not really. It's just that some mornings the women just won't get going, no matter how much you push.
You know the feeling.
How are the 42-stroke S's coming along?
Slowly.
You don't look so good. What did you get up to last night?
A few too many, that's all.
That's all? Marty, coming to work with a hangover that bad's just not on. Now, what are the women
found
out?
Come on, Mum. It was all in the line of duty.
Oh, really? I'd like to know how.
It was the only way I could get the captain to take the women on, for work experience. I ran into this old mate of mine from the Navy, Mickey. Now, his uncle, Captain Mulder, owns this boat, and we told him how we couldn't find an employer who'd help out. Anyway, to cut a long story short, he agreed to give it a go, but only on one condition. That I'd drink him under the table. So I did.
Has Mrs. Reynolds heard about it?
Oh, I left that to Delia, minus the bit about the drinking.
Oh, I should think so.
Don't worry, Mum. I'm not going to get sloshed every time I go down to the local for dinner. It's definitely a one-off.
Well, let's face it, a professional doesn't just go in half-cocked. These things need planning, discussions with the department.
The department also likes officers who take the initiative. Marty and Delia seem to have done that, wouldn't you say?
Oh, sure, I'm not knocking it, but we were always taught never to take chances with security.
Excuse me. Anne Reynolds. Yes, sister, what's the problem? Boils and rashes. You any idea why? Yes, well, keep an eye on the situation. Let me know if there's any change. Right. Now, Rodney, are you suggesting I shouldn't go ahead with this work offer at the boatyard?
Well, no, not exactly. What concerns me, Governor, are the security aspects. If the captain behaves on the boat like he did last night, who knows what might happen?
Oh?
Delia didn't tell you about the sculling contest.
Perhaps you should.
Well, for some unknown reason, Officer Jackson decided to win the captain over by challenging him to a drinking contest. Not very professional in my books.
Not in anyone's.
If you ask me, it just...
I didn't. I'd better have a word with the two of them. Ask them to come and see me, please.
Of course. Oh, Governor, I hope you don't think I'm mentioning all
this.
It's
all right, Rodney. You've made your point. I'll hear the rest from them.
Might have been a good idea if these sailors weren't such bad types.
Yes, well, I'll decide that. If they are, we can certainly forget the work release.
And if that doesn't work, we just try plan B.
What's that?
We stuff pillows up our shirts and make the lot of us look pregnant. Then Reno's got no choice. She'll have to send us all up there with you.
Someone ought to stuff a pillow up your mouth.
Oh, here, let me do that.
I'm not a bloody invalid.
No, you're pregnant. That means don't ever do it on your last day.
I keep telling you, it is not my bloody last day.
All fixed, everyone. Mrs. Pringles agreed that... I thought you were taking the skip out.
So I'm back. What's going on?
Nothing?
Nothing important. We just wanted to ask Mrs. Reynolds to do something for us.
What?
Oh, I'm running dry over here. How about a bit of work?
Yes, we'd better get going with this.
What's bloody going on? What's the big bloody secret?
Hey, damn, will you, Patterson?
How's it going, Mr. Jackson?
Are you all right?
Yeah, why shouldn't I be?
Because you've been on a bender, right? I reckon you'd be a rum man coming from the Navy.
None of your business. Got some good news for you all. Looks like the work project might be going ahead. Governor's looking over the project this morning.
What sort of work is it?
Hard work. You'd be doing maintenance on a ship down at the docks.
But how did you manage it? I got the impression it was hopeless.
Main thing is it's happening. Anyone afraid of a few blisters can still pull out.
Well, count me in. I can smell that fresh air already.
Governor wants to see you, Mr. Jackson.
All systems go, ladies.
Hey, Adams, you bagged any good movies lately?
I wouldn't get too cocky if I were you.
Oh, it sounds like you know something we don't.
Just get on with your work. All of you.
Of course.
Oh, just imagine all that sunshine.
Yes, I might get Reno to see if she can get Roach in on it. Might be just the thing to call her off.
What about me?
What about you?
Well, you're supposed to be seeing Reno about me, not about Roach.
So I'll make it a double. But you cop the verdict, you cop it sweet, all right?
One thing I don't need is my officers making fools of themselves in public, no matter what the reason.
But the drinking contest wasn't my idea,
Governor. You still took part.
I didn't really have any choice.
It was either that or lose our last chance to get the program off the ground.
Besides, we were off duty.
What if someone had found out you were trainees? You could have embarrassed both the prison and the department. I see.
It won't go any further, I promise you. I know these guys. Mix an old mate from the Navy.
Hardly a recommendation for supervising convicted prisoners.
Well, they seemed honest enough to me, Mrs. Reynolds. Godsend after all the knockbacks we've had.
Well, I suppose it won't hurt to follow it up.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
You won't be disappointed.
I wouldn't get my hopes up. The department has strict guidelines for work experience employers. Judging from last night's activities, I'm not sure these friends of yours will measure up.
Jeez, where did you spring from?
Where have you been? I've been looking all over for you.
Collecting the two up winnings. Good money, innit? Especially if you're running the school.
It won't bring you happiness, though, will it? And the contacts on the outside and get you plenty of that.
Well, you're still not going on about that, are you?
Too right. I'm going out in the laundry truck.
Hey, the screws checked, the bags. You wouldn't even get past the loading bay.
So who says I'll be in a bag? They'll be so busy checking the bags, they won't think of looking for anyone on the roof.
Well, how are you going to get up there, fly?
No, climb up. While you're talking to the driver.
That creep?
I'm not asking you to propose to him, just keep him busy. By the time you get ticked off, I'm already up there.
And?
That's it. Your part anyway. I just lay low and I'm gone. Well, what do you reckon?
I don't know, Reg.
I said I'd make it worth your while. I'll get you anything you want.
Coke?
Coke, grass, you name it.
You're on.
Beauty. Look, I'll meet you in my cell as soon as the end of work bell goes.
Yeah, no worries. Waters, I don't like reneggers.
Who does?
Yeah, that's right, this morning. So just don't give her any reason to knock you back. It's not my fault if I can hold my liquor, is it? Yeah, see ya. And get the place shipshape, okay? Bye.
Someone's sure going out of their way to sabotage us.
Mm, three guesses.
Now a toast, success.
I'm surprised you didn't tell her I gave you that shiner, too. You told her everything else.
What are you talking about?
Last night, you dobbed us in. Squealed like a stuck pig.
I reported disorderly conduct likely to reflect adversely on the department.
Word for word, straight out of the manual.
I'll let it go, Marty.
Pity there isn't a name for officers who lag on their mates.
There is, professional. And don't bother with the mates.
Here.
Ta.
Caught me off guard last night, Jackson.
The only reason I didn't clobber you earlier was because I met Mickey.
Because you hadn't had enough to drink, you mean.
Go away, Rodney.
Dutch courage, wasn't it? You could have hit me just then, but you backed down.
The penalty for striking a fellow officer on duty is suspension and dismissal. Paragraph 36, subsection C. You're just not worth losing a job over, mate.
You think you're smart with this work experience stuff, don't you? Well, it's not going to come off. Not if I can help
it. Stop being so childish.
Hey, you forgot your herbal tea. If I didn't know any better, I'd say Roddy boy's a little bit jealous.
Where have you been? You took your time, didn't you?
What are you talking about? I came down to
see. All right.
Hey, you're not freaking out enough.
No,
right?
No way. You ready?
Any time.
Let's go.
Grumpy. Ah, still grumpy, I see. I've got something for you.
Whatever it is, I don't want it.
Which hat?
Look, will you stop treating me like a kid?
All right, I'll take this letter back to Mrs. Morris.
Hang on, who's it from? Not Chucky.
I thought you said you didn't care.
Yeah, well, I didn't know what it was. Come on, hand it over.
Not when you use that tone of voice.
All right, I'm sorry for sounding so pushy.
And for being so ungrateful to Rita.
Oh, come on, I was just mouthing
off. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Here we are. Dinner.
Oh, beauty.
I convinced Mrs. Morris to let me have the letter so you wouldn't have to wait for the mail tomorrow.
the wine, Jules.
Well, come on, are you going to fill me in or leave me in the dark?
She says Steve's got himself a job near the prison and she sees a real lot of him. She's learning how to look after little farm. Hey, she's thinking of becoming a vet. Oh, she ought to. I mean, she's got the brains for it.
Feeling better now?
Better. I feel like bloody strangling myself.
Come on, Lexie, snap out of it.
Why? She's going great guns and I'm copping maternity.
I've arranged to make the phone call to Uncle Arnold about the overalls and you'll be able to help me with all the measurements.
Look, stop your bloody overalls. I'm not going with you anyhow.
We've tried to keep you involved so you wouldn't feel left out.
Oh, it's a bit late, isn't it? What about you and your bloody secrets?
Well, that's just something between Nancy and Rita. And
yeah, well, between you and me. Rack off, I've had a gutful.
Lexie!
You heard.
I'm sorry for trying to cheer you up.
But there must be a mistake. I was told quite clearly...
Any news from the Building Society?
Oh, look, I'm on the phone to them now. But the branch manager assured us it was just a formality. We've planned everything around it. Look, I understand, but I want... Oh, I see. Then there's nothing we can do. Goodbye.
What happened?
There's been a downturn in the money market. They're limiting the amount of money available for finance and... we missed out.
You can't be serious.
Apparently it was on the news this morning. We were so busy organising around Joan that we missed it.
We'll just have to tell Joan we can't leave.
But she has to stay with us. Where else can she go?
I could make a few suggestions.
Oh, Mervyn.
They haven't accepted her offer yet, have they?
Not yet. But she's pretty certain they will. Mervyn, I'm so sorry. Oh. I didn't realise anything like this could happen.
Love, it's not your fault. The question is, what are we going to do? We can't stay if she owns the flat.
I don't know, Mervyn. I just don't know.
Come on, you two, let's keep it moving.
Blonde one's not bad. G'day.
Well, are you going to give me the ball or do I have to get it off you?
Haven't decided yet. Had me eyeing you for quite a while, you know that?
Well, what do you know? I was just going to say the same thing about you.
Yeah?
What's going on here?
Just helping out.
You're lucky I don't put you on a charge, McPherson.
Well, Jason, the ball.
Just get back with the other women now. I've a good mind to report you to the governor.
You just do that, Sonny.
Listen, are we supposed to be chair?
McPherson, have you seen Rach in your travels?
No, why?
Oh, Renna's not going to let her out. I thought it might as well be the bunny who tells her.
What do you mean, not letting her out?
Well, work experience is full up.
What's so interesting down there?
Nothing.
Bloody hell, who's that mad bugger? Huh? It's Rach.
Start tossing the ball and get the screws busy.
Oh, do it!
Otherwise, I'll be using you for a volleyball.
Make sure I brush my teeth next time too, okay?
What's so funny?
And Rita?
Yeah, I've seen them.
Where the bloody hell are they?
You could say they were doing their work experience a bit early. Last time I saw them, they were riding shotgun on the laundry truck.
They've done a bunk?
Well,
They're not doing it for the money.
Struth! Payroll or what?
I'm just trying to stop you being a jerk. It ain't easy.
What? I was in the clear.
Oh, come off it. How far do you reckon you're going?
Far enough. But you're making it hard. Look, that fence ain't so high. You coming with me or what?
Oh, sure. We just stroll down the street with this clobber on, get a taxi to the region.
Well, suit yourself.
You ain't going nowhere.
Look, you might be gutless, lady, but I know what I'm
Listen,
doing.
You'll be lucky to last 2 hours. Is that worth risking another 6 months?
I'd settle for 2 minutes. Bongo got me in here and you've been ordering me around like a traffic cop ever since. I'm sick of the bloody lot of yous.
Now we can keep doing this all day or we can go back inside before it hits the fan.
Look, just stop telling me what to do. Rack off.
Okay. But you go over that fence, that's it, Roach. Finished.
Don't you tell anyone you ever rode with me.
Are you sure no one saw nothing?
It went off like a dream. That knuckle nut Adams was hanging around.
What?
I had him twirled around the little finger.
Jeez, Reed'll have your guts setting this up without her say-so.
I don't know. I reckon she'd be thanking me by now.
Oh, jeez. Well, we'll have to give her plenty of cover. You start spreading the word. Everyone's seen Reed and Roach and no one knows where they are.
You giving the orders now, eh?
Will you just do it?
Mm, whatever you say. You won't be the only one in the race.
Huh? What race?
You don't fancy yourself as the new top dog?
Oh, yeah, that race. Top dog.
All right, you lot, I want a word with you.
Anyone on board? Mr. Muldoon?
Captain, to you, lady. Oh, Mrs. Reynolds, is it?
Yes. Morning.
Yeah, thought you might have been that damned salesman again. Just clearing the decks.
Yes, well, if you've finished, we might be able to discuss your offer of work experience for some of my women.
Yes, of course, sir. Have you be coming down with them?
No, but they will be under tight security. I think you met two of my officers last night.
Oh, yeah, young Marty and little Delia. Yeah, I hope he's suffering twice as much. Oh, this is my first mate, Mickey.
Morning.
I must admit I've got some reservations about this scheme.
You and me both.
The captain's from the old school. Women were considered bad luck on the old sailing ships.
Watch it, boy.
I'm all for equal opportunities myself. You'd agree with that, wouldn't you, Mrs. Reynolds?
Yes, as long as the work isn't too much for them physically.
I'm not running holiday camp here if they can't pull their weight.
No, of course not. It's mainly a restoration maintenance job. A bit of scraping and painting, that sort of thing.
Yeah, plenty of hard yakka.
I'm sure the girls could cope all right.
Sure they could, but that's not the point.
And there's a lot more they can learn too. Mechanics and electronic gear is quite up to date. There's plenty for them to set their minds to.
Is this the salesman you were talking about?
Thinks he is.
You might just like to take a look at her.
I will. As I was telling the captain, they'll be under tight security. They don't miss many opportunities to take advantage of a situation.
Well, they won't get around me. I run a tight ship here.
Glad to hear it.
Step it up there, Kennedy. We haven't got all day.
Let's keep it down to a dull roar, shall we, Mr. Adams?
Just letting them know we're here, Miss Ferguson.
Sure, they're well aware of that.
Oh, did you have a nice lunch, Miss Ferguson? I was just saying to Vicky that...
Where are the others?
Others?
Well, Connors for one and Waters.
Must have missed them.
If they'd come through, I'm sure
Rubbish.
We would have...
Oh, they're already inside. Fair dinkum. We're the last. You and Mr. Adams must have been having a giggle.
Just watch your mouth, Jenkins.
Oh, honest. Reed got something in her eye. Said she'd meet us inside, didn't she?
Yeah.
Yeah, I told
you. Mr. Adams, get some officers and search the grounds.
But I'm finishing
this. Now, Mr. Adams.
Of course.
Gate guard.
Bloody hell. Get down, there's screws everywhere.
Better raise the alarm. There's no use giving him a head start.
We'll check the grounds first. It might be another one of their pranks.
Look, we're up the creek, Rita. They haven't hit the alarms yet. We've still got time.
No way! We'll take the side fence.
I wonder if they've got shooters.
Oh, have you ever heard of anyone being shot breaking into a prison?
Yeah, your brother.
Nah, she'd be halfway to Sydney on a Harley by now.
Not if she's got any sense, she wouldn't.
Quiet as a church out there. They could be in solitary.
Nah, I reckon the screw's a stump. They made it, the lucky buggers.
Oh, not so lucky. Have you forgotten what it was like to be on the run?
Oh, a piece of cake. Just lie low for a while.
No, eh? Won't be that easy for them.
No, Nancy's right. No money, no clothes, not even a roof.
And they can't go to their gang because the police will be waiting for them.
Maybe they might meet someone nice.
If you'd have known, you could have lent them one of your uncles.
All right, keep it down. They got a chance, maybe. Better we know nothing about it and keep this place running normal.
Yes. Oh, I just hope Mrs. Reynolds doesn't cancel our work experience. The overalls are arriving in the morning. It'd be such a shame.
Maybe I could have a word with her when everything cools down.
Sure aren't going to be no picnics. Screws are going to be on our backs and we ain't got no top dog.
Yeah, well, I've been thinking about that.
Oh, spare us, Lurch. Things are bad enough.
Well, someone's got to use their nut. Reet wouldn't want us falling to pieces.
And who's going to do that?
Me. Well, you can't say I don't have the experience. Learned a few tricks on both sides of the fence.
Yeah, always a bridesmaid, never the bride. Lurch, I'll do my own thinking, thanks.
Yeah, well, how are you going to keep tabs on Maxwell? You won't even be here. I want to put it to the vote right now.
You two.
Hey,
come on.
What's up?
On your feet. You've got this place turned upside down looking for you.
Oh, no.
What is it?
Well, I was lying on this beach in the Solomon Islands and Harrison Ford was just kneeling down beside me. And you know what he was doing?
You can fly back there after lights are out tonight. Now back inside or we'll be on charges.
Right. What was he doing?
There you go, Lex, the condemned Ada Hardy.
Oh, you sound bloody glad to get rid of me.
Of course not. We have to celebrate your last night.
Oh, we can take it in turns to come and see you.
Oh, great help. That's going to be...
Yeah, last time I was
in... I hear they all voted informal. Thanks for holding the fort, Lurch. I'll be glad to have you as my chief mechanic any time.
Thanks, Rose.
All right, you lot. Here's a toast. To Lexie and the next little warrior.
Oh. Yeah.
Come on, Roach, don't be such a spoil sport.
Leave her alone.
Don't hold your breath.
Oh, g'day, Mr. Jackson. You come to join the party.
Hey, yeah, we could use a good dancer.
Maybe some other time. But I do have something to say while you're all here.
Hey, you're going to take us out to dinner?
You could say that.
Hey, you're not serious.
Well, not exactly dinner, but Miss Stout and I have been trying to get approval for work experience down at the docks.
And what's the verdict?
Mrs. Reynolds went to look over the project this morning.
Well, come on, what'd she say?
She's quite happy to let the project go ahead. It's not going to be a joyride, mind you. You're going to have to prove that you want to work. And the officers will be there to make sure that you do.
Oh, Miss Ferguson will probably nail our feet to the deck.
Oh, come on, Lurch, give her a break. Besides, they probably won't let the deputy governor out on something like that, would they, Mr. Jackson?
Sure, I think she's down for duty on the second day, actually.
Is that right?
Right, Maxwell, your time's up. I trust your stay in here wasn't too uncomfortable.
Useful, Miss Ferguson. Very useful.
Maxwell, I'm not usually wrong when I have a hunch about the women in here. And something tells me to keep an eye on you.
Good advice. But you're wasting your time here, Miss Ferguson.
I want to know what you're up to.
I'd be rather stupid to confide in you, wouldn't I? Unless I thought we could both come out on top.
Yeah, you do have a plan.
You can't survive in here without one, but that's not enough.
Go on.
Let's just say I want a lot of compensation if I'm going to rot in here for 20 years, and I know just how to get it.
You're going to use the system to feather your nest, make life easier for you.
I'll do much better than that.
Forget it, Maxwell. He'd only make trouble for the pair of us.
Trouble's easy to avoid if you use your brains. And they're as scarce as hen's teeth around here.
Oh, come on. Look, I've seen them come and go. Even the strong ones get ripped apart after a while.
Only if they're vulnerable. I've already got my muscle. All I need is a little outside help. A little well-paid outside help.
Come on, you're wasting my time.
It's one thing I've got plenty of.
Lurch! Thought you could do with the bodyguard when you're upstairs. Geez, I never thought I'd see you lost for words.
So that's why you've been cutting me out all the time.
Well, we couldn't ruin the surprise.
I thought it was because I was no good to the gang anymore.
Oh, you're always going to be in the gang.
If you don't look after yourself, you have to answer to all of us.
Oh, I feel like a real gig shooting my mouth up all the time now.
Yeah, I thought you'd never put a sock in it.
Aye.
Thought you could call him Biggles.
Biggles, eh? Oh, what a cutie. Thanks, everyone. It's the best prezi.
He's a bit big for nappy practice.
Oh, I reckon. Yeah. How'd you get him in?
Well, we had to con Mrs. P, but she was apples. Mm. Until she had to hand him over, then we saw a tear in her eye.
Good on Mrs.
Most
P.
Most of the other officers chipped in too.
Yeah.
Okay, you lot, you've had your moment. Those going to work experience are at the first sitting, right?
Most of them chipped in.
What was that, Jenkins?
Chips. For breakfast, maybe.
Don't be a fool. Come on, Patterson, you haven't got all day.
Sure you don't want a quick cuddle?
Get a move on.
She needs a nice big teddy bear to cuddle too.
She'd probably beat all the other kids' teddy bears to death at kindergarten.
Look after yourself, love. We'd better go.
Yeah, bye.
See tons and tons of you.
Yeah, cheer up. The place is losing a bit of class, that's all, but it's not forever.
A deal's a deal, kid.
You've got rocks in your head.
Well, what was I going to do? She's had a 10-foot door.
All you had to do was stall her for 5 minutes. Even a thick head like you could have done that.
And if Rita punched holes in me, that wasn't part of the deal, and you still owe me.
You're whistling in the dark, kid. Just stay out of my way.
I stuck my neck out on my office.
No, door. What are you, a giraffe or something?
All right, all right. You can forget the rest of the stuff. I'll settle for some of your buy-up.
Crap, you will.
Tomorrow morning, I'll bet I can run even faster.
Oh, that's good, Mel. If you keep practicing, like you're reading, for instance, you're bound to get better and better.
Yeah, but I've got to run faster, too.
Well, I'm not so sure about that one. You know the officers don't like it.
Yeah, but I got it. Sister Hall said I was a bit slow.
She's been real good to me. She said you and me are going to work together and everything.
Mm, yeah, that'll be fun. Mel, why don't you go on to breakfast? I'll join you there in a moment.
Yeah, I'll go with you, Mel. I don't know why I'm wasting my time with you.
Off you go. I want to have a word with both of you.
I'll tell them you're coming.
Thanks. I hope you two haven't had a falling out.
She's welshing on a deal and I want what's coming to me.
Well, that is a shame.
Bitch always wants something for nothing.
Well, I think you two had better resolve your differences if you're going to be working together again.
Get off it! I wouldn't work with her if you paid me.
Oh, you'll be paid all right. But from now on, you'll both be working for me.
Yes, I see, sister. I'll get Mrs. Morris to come up straight away. I understand. It would be, yes. Let me know as soon as you find out anything else. Thank you.
And the women's clothes for the work experience have arrived.
Just a moment, please. Can you get Mrs. Morris to report to my office straight away? Thank you. Good, you'd better get them distributed. The women will have to leave in half an hour.
There may be some doubt about that. I think you'd better have a look.
I see what you mean.
Of every pimp in the state following them around.
They're hardly what I expected.
Well, Uncle Arnold must have got his wires crossed. But they're lovely, aren't they? Well, these are a lot more practical.
Oh, very practical. I'll have them issued with regulation overalls,
Gavin. Yes, I think that'd
be a good
idea.
Well, they'd be very easy to move in.
But we don't want to see everything move in them, do we, Wilkinson?
We could wear T-shirts underneath them. If we wear prison issue, everyone will know where we're from and what we are.
It's good for security.
That is not fair. Everyone will be pointing at us and laughing at us. Please, Mrs. Reynolds, I mean, the girls will be thrilled a bit.
They're provocative and demeaning.
I don't think they'd suit you or me, Miss Ferguson, but as long as the women are suitably covered, I don't see why they shouldn't wear them.
Well, Mrs. Reynolds, I could hug you.
Perhaps you'd better save your energy for the boat.
G'day, Mr. Biggles.
Pleased to meet you. It's not exactly the Hilton, but I guess it's home.
How touching. I underestimated you, Patterson. Soft little heart beating in there after all, is there?
Sure not beating for you.
Get your stuff.
Time for the baby boom, is it?
Well, at least it'll take the wind out of your sails for a while.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on it. Get your mitts out of there.
Not much for a 20-year-old, is it?
I'm doing all right.
Oh, sure you are. But there's a lot waiting for you when you get out. Big house by the beach, two cars in the garage and two studs to drive them. That's what you dream about, isn't it? Well, you'd love to hit me, wouldn't you? Go on. Look at you. A dirty little hustler knocked up by someone on a garbage truck. Pathetic, isn't it?
Yeah, that's it. No fun, no future.
Tell me one thing, Patterson. Why did you pick me out for your stunts?
Could be, because you're always on our backs.
Yes.
The truth is, you're the biggest suck we ever had in here.
We'll have to be leaving in a few minutes.
You'll have to hurry, Wilkinson.
Ready? Oh, no, we're not. Oh. Direct from the cutting rooms of La Méchante Fille for a day at the poolside or maybe lounging around on a boat in the harbour.
My goodness.
Well, they certainly didn't waste much material on your Zoraline.
And now here's Rita. Colourful look. Notice the free line of the trousers and a lovely loose shirt.
Should be just the thing for the 20s pansy picnic.
Oh, I don't know. It's a change from denims anyway.
Conquerors would reckon you're a real pansy.
Nah, you watch. All the wharfies would be off on sickies. Yes.
And now for the older woman, who's still playful at heart.
Come on, Nate.
Oh, I'm not that playful at heart. Oh, I feel ridiculous.
Excited, the best looking mum in town.
Oh, she's got a lovely figure, don't you think, Mr. Jackson? Oh,
yes, yes, of course.
There you go, now it's a vote for the older woman.
Am I on yet? Oh! Yeah. Oh,
let's get moving.
Sit down, come on. Get going, we'll be late for
guess I got a bit carried away.
You ought to do a tour, Lurch. They'd love you at Woodridge.
I think their escape record is pretty high as it is.
Just remember that the success of this program depends on your behaviour inside the prison as well as out. Miss Stout, Mr. Jackson have gone to a lot of trouble over this.
If this one goes well, we can use it as an example to get something else on the road.
You just keep your peepers on the road. She's a drop and a half down there.
Jeepers. Hey, look at all them little boats. Where are we?
Oh, it's Westgate, Alice. Have you ever been here before?
Lurch was at Wentworth when it was still a vacant loft. They built the place up around her.
Oh, Mr. Jackson, we'll be arriving soon?
You can see our dock over there on the left. That line of red roofs.
Oh, is that the ship? Isn't it huge?
That's an oil tanker.
Oh, thank heavens for that.
Alice, are you all right?
I ain't seen it since I was a kid.
Seen what?
The sea. I built a huge sandcastle once, but the waves washed it away.
Don't worry, Lurch. Mr. Jackson will break out the bucket and spade as soon as we get there.
Hello!
Oh, give it a rest, Mel. You're giving me a headache.
It's real dark and scary in there. It's like having your eyes closed. You want to try?
No, look, I'd rather keep my eyes open around here. Look, why don't you jump in and shut the door? It'd be a really good place to hide.
Yeah, it would.
Mel, come over here and give me a hand, will you?
Oh, yeah.
Show me how to make the smoke. Okay, now you put the tea towel in like that, and then you take the handle of the press and you pull it down like that.
I got it! Good. Any problems?
No. But they weren't cheap, bud. I had to hock everything, and some of the stuff's on credit.
Well, our little money spinners will soon fix that.
Yeah? You gonna show me how to work this?
Oh, no, look, go by the door and tell me if someone's coming, all right?
All right. At least I'll learn how to make the smoke. Look, put this on. Flip it around. Hooky.
Wonderful. That should keep our little friends in uniform totally in the dark.
Pretty neat, eh? Pastry. It checks the dots. Josie made them on kitchen duty.
Ingenious.
These are loaded.
You slip them in when the bets are high. They come up snake size every time.
Looks like some of our mates are going to get plucked.
Oh, we can afford a few winners.
Even better. Connors gets wind that this isn't on the up and up, you can kiss your casino goodbye.
Connors can do what she likes. With these little beauties, I can buy and sell that thug a dozen times over.
Lurch, he got off on the sea, but she's apparently changed her mind.
I said I like playing it, not drowning in it.
Well, all those who can't swim stay well away from the rails when we're on the boat.
Ship.
I thought you said it was a tug.
Now, look, I want you all to fall in over there. Now, don't go wandering off. You'll be told what to do.
Hey, if that's the captain, I'm signing on for the whole cruise.
Hey, Mr. Jackson.
G'day, Mick.
Ladies.
Joyce.
Howdy, do.
Howdy, do. The captain will be along in a minute. You might just like to take a look at it.
Oh, yeah. Great.
There she is, the grand old what?
God bless all who sail in her.
Is she safe?
Not with us on board.
Oh, just imagine. Cocktail parties, I mean, tropical sunsets and dinner with the captain and
all right, all right.
Stop standing around boring holes in the paintwork. Like a pack of seagulls. Those of you who are supposed to work, get cracking. Right now.
Struth, it's Captain Hook.
Oh, Meg, have you seen that file on kitchen requisitions?
I wouldn't worry about that at the moment.
What's the matter?
Maternity's in chaos. Sister Hall's coming down to give you the details.
Fill me in
on
the
way. No, you can't go up there. It's not just boils and rashes.
Does she know what it is?
Well, she's not sure, but some of the women are really ill. She'll have to wait on the test results. But it looks like golden staph.
Oh, no.
Yes, well, everyone's in danger if that spreads. The whole area will have to be sterilised.
And quarantined.
Oh, those poor kids. Oh, hell, Lexie, Patterson, Rodney was taking her up there.
Oh, let's go.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too.